Simulan natin.
Magandang hapon po sa inyo lahat. Nag-prepare po ako ng speech na mahaba. Pagkatapos, iniksiyan ko pa. Mahaba na. Iniksiyan ko pa. Mabasahin ko na ang unang bahagi ng ating speech. Today, I rise before you on this momentous occasion, not only for myself, not only for the officers and members of this distinguished organization, not only for these participants, these honored participants, but for the more than 108 million Filipinos. This is my advocacy. My advocacy, which I contribute to this afternoon and to the 108 million Filipinos, is my own case in the Supreme Court that has been pending for the past 8 years. It was filed on January 25, 2013, and up to now it has not been decided by the Supreme Court for reasons of graft and corruption. The Supreme Court is not composed of all the 108 million Filipinos. It is composed of only 15 members, whereby this Supreme Court is divided into five members per division of three, so three divisions. These members are appointed by the President one by one, and they retire at the age of 70. So they do not represent truly the entire Filipino nation. I say that I contribute this case on this momentous occasion because it is a case that has been covered, that has been involved in many graft and corruption by not only the Philippine National Bank, but also judges of the Regional Trial Court, judges of the Court of Appeals, and even justices of the Supreme Court. Because this case was filed on January 25, 2013, and up to today, more than 8 years, hindi pa na-decide because of this graft and corruption in government. That is why, when we formulated our team, we entitled it The Vanguard, an advocacy for a speedy, orderly, fair, and affordable justice. SOFF, S-O-F-A, SOFA. The case was filed on July 22, 1981, and it has not been decided, it has not been terminated up to now for a period of 40 years. I will make it brief. On July 10, 1980, the Philippine National Bank executed a deed of promise to sell in favor of the spouses Eligio P. Mallari and Marcelina I. Mallari, whereby the PNB sale vendor and the spouse Mallari are the vendors. And up to this day, for the past more than 40 years, hindi pa po natapos because of graft and corruption. 13 cases were won by the spouse Mallari, and these cases were decided with finality in favor of the Spyfresh Mallari, and the Philippine National Bank never won a single case in these 13 cases. They filed their petition for certiorari on January 7, 2009. A petition that is void, a petition that is prescribed, a petition that is wrong-based, a petition whereby they adopted a wrong remedy. A wrong remedy because as of the year 2008, zero rights na sila, wala nang karapatan sa lupang ito. Bakit nila ginagawa ang ganito? Sapagkat ang pinapangarap ng Philippine National Bank na chairman is sinusutan ay makuha again ang lupang ito. Pero ito ang masasabi ko. Mangyari, and the Philippine National Bank never won a single case in these 13 cases. They filed their petition for certiorari on January 7, 2009. A petition that is void, a petition that is prescribed, a petition that is wrong-based, a petition whereby they adopted a wrong remedy. A wrong remedy because as of the year 2008, zero rights na sila, wala nang karapatan sa lupa nito. Bakit nila ginagawa ang ganito? Sapagkat ang pinapangarap ng Philippine National Bank na chairman is si Lusutan ay makuha again ang lumpang ito. Pero ito ang masasabi ko, hindi nila dapat makuha ang lumpang ito sapagkat ang mga spouses mulyari, sila may-ari nito, sila nanalo sa lahat ng 23 kaso. Kung kaya pinending nila sa Korte Suprema na wala namang karapatan since 2008. In the lower court, nag-appeal na sila. Pero yung appeal, deny ng order ng Regional Fire Court, Branch 215, Quezon City, on May 13, 2008. Imagine, May 13, 2008. Nag-file sila na certiorari na zero rights na pa sila. Nag-appeal sila, natalo sila. Kung kaya ang aking mga asawa, ibibigay ko sa inyo, pinabibigay ko sa inyo yung notice of appeal. Sabi nila, natanggap nila yung decision of February 28, 2008 on March 12. Nag-file sila ng appeal on March 13, 2008. Dinina yan, natalo yan, at nagkaroon ng order of May 13, 2008, nag-issue ng rate of execution. Pina-inhibit nila yung West sa Branch 215, pinadala sa Branch 101. Ang Branch 101, in-affirm yung decision ng Branch 215 ng Quezon City, dated January 22, 2008. Na order ng RTC Branch 101 on November 25, 2008, in a firm line. Ang nangyari, dahil final na yung order of January 22, 2008, in-execute, in-implement, nilipat sa spouses mangyari ang title sa lupang yan, and the title became indivisible and incontrovertible pursuant to Section 38 of PD 1529. Kung kaya't nung mag-file ng petition for certiorari ang Philippine National Bank on January 7, 2009, zero rights and interest on the property. We have been paying on taxes on the property from 1980 up to 2021. We are in possession of the property from 1980 up to 2021. We want, in all cases, involving the properties from the regional trial court to the Supreme Court. We want, in the agrarian cases, na abogado ko, si Attorney Hermine Hildo Ocampo, asawa ni Mrs. Eleni Estelita Ocampo there. Nanalo kami from the DAR, Provincial DAR National Office of the President. And the decisions all became final and executory. Paano mong masasabi na nag-claim ka ng ownership? Sinishorten ko na lang po itong aking ano ito, kung kanya, inalis ko na yung aking speech para maintindihan nyo lahat ang ginawa. Because I do not want any Filipino. I do not want the 108 million Filipinos to suffer the consequences of an unjust legal battles for the past 40 years. Up to now, and the case is pending in one division of the Supreme Court. Nililipat-lipat from the Division 1 to Division 3. Ganun lang, hindi nila dinadala sa Division 2. Why? Because they want to control the proceedings. Why? Because there has been conspiracy, sabot-sabotan, from the Regional Trial Court to the Court of Appeals to the Supreme Court. Yung mga abogado involved sa Court of Appeals, inopos ko na ma-appoint sa Korte Suprema sa mga nagiging pangati. Hindi sila na-appoint. Inopos namin because of corruption. Why corruption? Because when you delay the decision of a case, pagdating sa Supreme Court, within which you have to decide within 2 years, that is in effect corruption because you are giving the other party an unjust advantage or unjust benefits. Under the Constitution, Article 8, Section 15, pag ang kaso ay umabot sa Supreme Court, the Supreme Court has to decide the case within 2 years, 2 years from the date it is submitted for decision, or within 2 years when the case with reference to pleadings and the last pleading is filed. The last pleading, that is the date when you have the 2 years period. In the case of the Supreme Court, when you file a petition for certiorari and there is an opposition or comment, after the comment or opposition of the other party, you file the reply. The petitioner who filed the reply, that will be the period from the date the 2 years period is to be counted. That is provided for under Article 8, Section 15, Number 1 and 2. So what is the effect of that? That will be, in effect, corruption. And they are liable to be answerable to criminal cases if filed in the with the ombudsman. Anong sabi ni former Commissioner Oceano Diado? Yung provision ng Section 15, Number 1, 2, 3, and 4, they are mandatory. Kanya, hindi applicable yung 1973 Constitution. Mandatory ito, sabi ng former Commissioner Oliedo in his book, Philippine Constitution Explained. So now, the justices involved are guilty of corruption under Republic Act 3019, Section 3E. They are entitled to this criminal offense. So if I have or my lawyers and the other people involved will be filing cases before the Ombudsman. Kaya na tayo to file sa Ombudsman. In effect, pinapapanagot namin ang mga justices na yan. Inimpisa namin kay Justice, Chief Justice Sereno. O paano ginawa ko? When I discovered in the hearings in the Committee on Justice na si Justice Sereno hindi nag-file ng siyam na salin, therefore, she lacks integrity. At the time of appointment, hindi na valido yung appointment, so the appointment is void. So, sumulat ako kay Galida, Solicitor General Galida. Pailan mo nang ko anto in my letter of February 21, 2018. Hindi pwede yung impeachment na yan. Matataro yan. Why? Because ang impeachment court ay ang members ng Senate. You have to get 16 or 2/3 out of the 24 members. Mahirap yan. Samantala nga sa Supreme Court, labing lima lang sila, you can just get the majority or majority 8. Ang papakunbig mo na. So ano yung nangyari? Nawala si Sereno. Today, I already filed 8 letters to Kalinda. Imanda mo, gamitin mo ang impeachment at gamitin mo yung co-warranto sa tatlong justices. Tatlong justices pa. I will not name them. But sumulat na ako ng 8 letters kay Kalinda. Please, gamitin mo yung co-warranto and remove this. Three justices, they are corrupt. Si Kalinda ayaw sumagot. Sumagot siya ng letter sa akin, pero hindi siya nag-confirm na papailan niya. Pero kung magko-confirm siya, magagamit niya yung co-warranto na ginamit niya kay Sereno. Because under the law, Rule 66 of the Rules of Court, it is only the Solicitor General that can file a case. As a private individual, as a lawyer, as a Filipino citizen, hindi ko pwedeng i-file ang co-warranto o ang karapatan. Kung kaya't sabi ko kay Galida, humingi ako ng kanyang appointment para i-explain ko why these three justices are liable for the crimes, for the offense they have committed, which will be or which are part or maybe grounds for co-warranto. Nagsulat ako, pinablis ko sa inquiry, co-warranto can be a ground to eliminate ineligible justices of the Supreme Court. Sabi ko, pwedeng gamitin ang co-warranto. Pwedeng gamitin kay isang justice dyan na inatake din sa diyaryo ngayon. Why? Because yung opinion ng iba, pag namalimutan mong gumawa ng offense na ganyan, hindi nag-submit ng salin, pwedeng gamitin yan. Hindi na pwedeng gamitin yan kasi nag-expire na. Hindi na pwedeng i-convict under the criminal law. Pero, ang katotohanan, we believe that crime is obliterated under the penal law or the criminal law. Hindi pwede sa constitutional provision of proven integrity. Because one can only be appointed justice one with competence, integrity, probity, and independence. Itong justice na ito, walang proven integrity. So based on that, pwede i-remove by co-warranto. So let us wait now what Solicitor General Galita will do. And I told him about this case na ang Philippine National Bank and file a petition for certiorari on January 7, 2009. The certiorari is void, prescribed, wrong based, wrong remedy, and sabi ko, we use it because of conspiracy. Conspiracy, which is a much graver offense than this proven indignity, than this RN getting committed dyan. Kasi pag nagsabota ng napakarami from the regional fire court to the court of appeals to the Supreme Court, pag nagsabota, I believe that is a greater or much graver offense than failure to file SAN alone, which is only provided for by the Constitution and provided by Law 6713. We now have the provision of the Supreme Court on lack of proven integrity. Tignan natin po kung anong gagawin niya. As I said, I contribute this for my advocacy. Tignan natin kung ano mangyayari. Bakit ko sinasabi nito? Hindi po lahat ng abogado, hindi lahat ng tao, hindi lahat ng mga businessmen, hindi lahat ng mga doctors o engineers yung nakakapag-file ng kaso kanyan, Korte Suprema, laban sa mga justices ng Korte Suprema. Lalamanan ka, mananagot ka dyan. Nagsasama-sama sila. Paano mo labanan yan? Malalabanan mo lang yan kung meron ka matibay na ebidensya, kung meron ka mga kaibigan na abogado, kung meron kang connection din, kung meron kang konting kwarta para sa ganun, patustusan mo ang gastos sa paglaban. Pag hindi mo nagawa yan, walang mangyayari sa iyo. Walang mangyayari sa iyo. At kawawa, natutunan ikaw, kawawa ang entire Filipino nation. That is why I say, and I adopt what a well-known author said, the cry of a child on the cradle. We say cry, that is not help. The cry of a child on the cradle is not a cry that should be heard. The cry of a child on the cradle is a cry in the wilderness. The cry of a child in the cradle is the cry likened to a candle in the wilderness, flickering, but the light is not seen. And when this child grows old, you the father, you the mother, you the grandfather, you the grandfather, it should not be that cry of the child alone who thirsts for justice, who is angry, who is sick, but you must be that father, that mother, that grandmother, that shall be making the cry now into one, a sound, a strong sound, a very, very strong sound to show you are thirsting for justice. You are going for that. Not hunger alone. You are longing for justice. You are longing for the truth. You are longing for this love of this country, for the love of the Filipino people. One that must now seek a better Philippines, one who will now seek a speedy, an orderly, a fair, and affordable justice. Justice does not be based on truth. Justice does not be based on the law. Justice must be based upon the fundamental law of the land. Justice whereby the Constitution shall prevail so that this country will become great again and be a part of the world that will be honored, that will be distinctly given priorities in economic, social, and religious freedom. Salamat po.